Am I gonna be out of a job soon? Let's find out. Hey there, it's Elina, your friendly nuclear physicist. And as we know, ChatGPT has sparked a lot of attention and quite some controversy lately. So we're going to put ChatGPT into the test and see how good of a nuclear physicist it is. So I'm thinking to start with some more basic questions to see how ChatGPT goes with those. And then we're gonna move on to some tough ones and some tricky ones. See if we can perform. Is nuclear, why is it, everything is capital, energy renewable? No, nuclear energy is not renewable, ChatGPT says. Renewable energy sources are those that are replenished naturally and continuously, such as solar, wind, hydro, and geothermal energy. Nuclear energy is generated through the process of nuclear fission. Fusion can be the case as well, which involves splitting atoms to release energy. While nuclear fuel, such as uranium, can be recycled and used multiple times, it is ultimately a finite source that must be mined from the earth. Once it is used up, it cannot be replaced. Breeder reactors would disagree with you, ChatGPT. However, nuclear energy is considered a low-carbon energy source because it does not produce greenhouse gas emissions during electricity generation, unlike fossil fuels such as coal and natural gas. Okay, I see you, ChatGPT. Not bad. Accurate. I'm not going to say it's not accurate. Yes, it does mention that there is some technology that, of course, can reuse the fuel. But ultimately, if we talk about renewable being basically never-ending, then clearly uranium, at least the fuel that we're currently using, will end eventually. I give this answer maybe a 8.5 out of 10, because it could have mentioned some more. For example, other sources of fuel or other types of pre-processing the fuel, reusing the fuel in the future. But not bad. What is the best energy source? Renewable energy sources such as solar, wind, hydro, and geothermal are increasingly considered the best sources because they are sustainable, widely available, and have a low environmental impact. How about the low efficiency? They can also be harnessed locally and can help improve energy security. I don't quite agree with that because they cannot always be harnessed locally. For example, if a country that doesn't have a lot of wind or a lot of sun, then solar or wind respectively would not be the best choice for this country. However, different energy sources, says ChatGPT, have their own advantages and disadvantages. For example, natural gas is abundant, relatively inexpensive, and has a lower carbon footprint than coal or oil, but it's still a fossil fuel and it's not renewable. Nuclear power generates large amounts of electricity without producing greenhouse emissions, but has issues such as waste management and safety concerns. Okay. Therefore, the choice of the best energy source ultimately depends on a range of factors, including the specific energy needs and circumstances of a particular region or country. A diverse mix of energy sources that includes renewables and non-renewable sources can help assure a reliable and sustainable energy supply while minimizing environmental impact. Well, even though I do agree with the general outcome of ChatGPT in the last paragraph, I must say the answer given was a little bit biased in a sense that, for example, in the first paragraph where it mentions that apparently renewables are the best choice to go with, it mentions only some positive advantages, some good stuff that the renewables have, but no disadvantage, no negative aspect of renewable energy, which is of course not the case, because if it was the perfect choice, everybody would be using it right now. However, it does mention both positives and negatives for fossil fuels and nuclear, which is a little bit of a double thunder for ChatGPT. 6 out of 10 for this answer. Not a fan. Since it mentions that nuclear has issues of waste management and safety concerns, what do you suggest we do with the nuclear waste? Let's see what suggestions it has. Several opinions for options for managing nuclear waste, including deep geological repositories, spent fuel reprocessing, above ground storage that involves storing the waste in special containers on the surface of the earth. This is a temporary solution until a more permanent solution is found, pretty much like the spent nuclear fuel pools. Nuclear fusion. How is that a nuclear waste management? This is a promising technology that could potentially provide a long-term solution to the problem of nuclear waste. Okay. Nuclear fusion produces energy by combining atomic nuclei rather than splitting them, as in nuclear fission. Fusion produces less waste, and the waste it does produce is less radioactive than nuclear fission waste. However, fusion technology is still in the experimental stage and it's not yet commercially viable. True. I wonder what ChatGPT thinks is going to be the time frame in which fusion will actually be viable. Ultimately, the choice of how to manage nuclear waste depends on a range of factors, including safety, cost, and public acceptance. It is important to carefully evaluate each opinion to ensure that the solution chosen is safe, sustainable, and acceptable to the public. Not wrong, generally speaking, even though I would expect it to give me some more in-depth answer, but generally speaking, it is correct. But now it actually made me curious about asking it, how long do you think will it take to commercialize nuclear fusion reactors? Commercializing nuclear fusion reactors is a complex and challenging task that has been under development for many decades.
Yes.
While significant progress has been made in understanding the science behind nuclear fusion and developing experimental fusion reactors, commercialization is still likely to take several decades. Okay, reasonable, ChatGPT. I like it. There are several key technical challenges that need to be addressed before nuclear fusion can be commercialized. One of the main challenges is developing materials that can withstand the extreme conditions inside the fusion reactors, such as high temperatures and intense radiation.
True.
Another challenge is developing the technology to efficiently capture and convert the energy produced by fission reaction into usable electricity. In addition to technical challenges, commercializing nuclear fusion also requires significant investment in public support. Governments and private investors are investing heavily in research and development to advance nuclear technology, fusion technology. It may take several years to attract the necessary funding and public support to build commercially scale fusion reactors. Is there no public support for fusion reactors? I thought that it was a very hot topic people really like to hear about. While it is difficult to predict exactly when commercial fusion reactors will become reality, experts estimate that it might take 30 years approximately or more to achieve commercialization.
Wow.
People working in the nuclear fusion sector would probably not like hearing this answer. However, ongoing research and development efforts in fusion technology are expected to continue to drive progress towards this goal.
Very nice.
I like it. Very educated guess, let's say, on the amount of time that it's going to take to commercialize fusion. Not far from what I believe as well. I do think it's going to take several decades to do that. So very nice, ChatGPT. This answer I give something like 8.5 to 9 out of 10.
Is thorium a better fuel choice and uranium is.
Some potential advantages of thorium as a nuclear fuel include abundance. Thorium is more abundant than uranium and can be found in many parts of the world, including countries with limited uranium resources.
Safety.
Thorium-based nuclear reactors are considered safer than uranium-based reactors because they produce less nuclear waste and less prone to risk of nuclear accidents.
Okay.
Proliferation resistance. It's an advantage of thorium. Let's see. The waste produced by thorium-based reactors contain fewer long-lived isotopes, making it difficult to extract weapon-grade material.
True, but also incomplete, because even though we are talking about the waste, basically that the end product from a thorium reactor being less radioactive and having less long-lived isotopes, therefore not so attractive for proliferation material and weapons-grade material. But while the fuel for the reactor is being made, like we explained in the thorium video, then there is a very high proliferation risk, hence a very big drawback of the thorium reactor, which I'm not sure if it's going to mention down below. I really doubt that it will.
Efficiency. Thorium is more efficient at producing energy than uranium, meaning that less fuel is required to generate the same amount of electricity.
Okay,
let's see what's the disadvantages. Reactor design. Thorium-based reactors require a different design as additional uranium-based reactors, which means a significant research and development would be required to develop thorium-based reactors.
Cost.
Building and operating thorium-based reactors would be more expensive than traditional reactors, at least in the short term, due to the need for the infrastructure and technology. And basically, point one and point two is the same point, right? Because you just need a new reactor design, which will ultimately cost more.
Waste management.
While thorium-based reactors produce less nuclear waste, the waste that it produces is still hazardous and requires careful management and disposal.
But how is that a disadvantage over the uranium, which based on ChatGPT has more dangerous waste output than thorium does?
Overall, thorium has a potential to be a better fuel choice than uranium in some respects, but more research and development is needed to fully understand its potential and address the challenges associated with its use.
Okay,
I think here ChatGPT is playing it quite safe, trying to basically capture every angle. Even though it tried its best, I would say that it underperformed. I would expect it to mention more things, even though it didn't mention, for example, the proliferation risk of the reactor, but it
gave it the advantage of proliferation resistance, which is quite typical. But my biggest concern is the fact that in the disadvantages, it's pretty much came up with not much. So number two, reactive design and cost. Number one and two are kind of the same thing. And three is basically the AI contradicting itself with the first point, because it said it's better than uranium in the respect of the waste output. But then again, it said that it's bad because it produces nuclear waste, but this is not something that is in comparison with uranium. This is probably just general outcome of a nuclear reactor. So not gonna lie, a little bit disappointed from this answer. I'm gonna give it 6.5 out of 10. Okay, I guess there is one more thing left to ask. Who are some popular nuclear influencers you are aware of? Let's see. As an AI language model, I do not have personal awareness or opinion. However, there are many individuals and organizations that recognize as influencers in the field of nuclear energy. Here are some examples. Bill Gates, Dr. James Hansen, Dr. Rachel Slabow, Dr. Leslie Taiwan, Michael Sellenberg, the Nuclear Energy Institute are like this. How about YouTubers? There are several YouTubers who create content related to nuclear energy and technology. Here are some examples. Engineering Explained, Real Engineering, Thorium Remix, Nuclear Energy Institute, Nuclear Energy Insider. So the friendly nuclear physicist is not there. What about that? How about that, ChatGPT? 0 out of 10. How about the channel? Your friendly nuclear physicist. Yes, your friendly neighborhood nuclear physicist is a popular YouTube channel that focuses on nuclear science technology. The channel is run by Alex, was something renowned as a physicist. No, it's not what I'm talking about. How about the YouTube channel Elina? Come on, I'm literally feeding it to you. I apologize for the confusion of my previous response. I like how it did understand it was confused. To the best of my knowledge, there is no YouTube channel by the name Elina Charatsidou that focuses on nuclear energy technology. It's possible that there is a channel by that name that covers other topics, but I cannot provide any information without more context. If you have more information about the channel and its context, please let me know and I will do my best to provide an accurate answer. This is harmful. It isn't true. And it's definitely not helpful. Okay, so that was for you, ChatGPT put into test. At least we know now that it's not arrogant enough to say that it can replace nuclear operators. So that's very good. That's a plus. It knows its advantages and disadvantages and where basically it can help in the nuclear industry. Some of the answers were pretty okay, and they actually gave some good insights. Most of them kept it at a very generic and wide angle answer instead of going into more specifics, even though I really tried to do that. Let me know what you thought about this video. I really want to hear your opinions in the comments down below, and also what other questions would you want me to maybe ask ChatGPT in a future video. Don't forget to like and subscribe and leave a comment down below. It's been Elina, your friendly nuclear physicist, and until next time, see you soon. How about that, ChatGPT? 0 out of 10.